Welcome to APE. In this video, we will introduce the unboxing and installation of APE's autocorrelator pulseCheck NX. pulseCheck NX provides fast and easy measurement of the pulse duration of an ultrafast laser. This is the shipment box of pulseCheck NX. Make sure the box and its contents have time to reach room temperature to avoid condensation inside the device. Remove the foam layer and take out the accessory case. When you open the accessory case, make sure the APE logo is facing upward. Inside, you'll find one or several detectors and crystals necessary for your measurement needs. Before installation, block the incoming laser beam and place the pulseCheck NX on the optical table where you can easily walk the beam later. To install the detector, remove the top lid. Connect the detector cable to the detector and lower it into its mount. You will hear a click sound when the detector slides into the correct position and the magnet snaps in. Then close the top lid. To install the crystal, push the bottom of the crystal hatch slightly to flip it open. Insert the crystal and turn it until you hear a click sound from the magnet snapping in when the pin matches the slot. Finally, close the cover. Fasten the pulseCheck NX on the optical table. Take note of the test report, which is one of the documents that are provided. Set the screw value for beam distance according to the test report. There are two measurement modes available, collinear and non-collinear. The manual offers more information about the two modes. Here we start with collinear mode, where only one spot is visible on the crosshair. Also, set the screw value for focus. For the pulseCheck NX 50 model, also set the screw value for delay. Flip down the two input apertures to center the beam more easily later. Then, remove the beam block and direct the beam to the first input mirror. If the laser beam is not visible, use appropriate IR cards or an IR beam viewer. With the help of the two input apertures, which are flipped down, adjust and center the beam into the input aperture. Use the screws of the input mirror to align the laser beam through the second aperture and thereafter to the crosshair. After the precise alignment, flip the two apertures up to pass the entire beam diameter. Connect the power supply. Connect the pulseCheck NX to the PC with either the USB or the Ethernet cable and turn the pulseCheck NX on. If you have connected the pulseCheck NX via USB, installing the software is not necessary. Simply copy the software to your PC or start it directly from the data drive included in pulseCheck NX. If it is connected to the Ethernet network, pulseCheck NX will show up as a network device. You can double-click it to open its webpage and download the software to the PC. For our demonstration, let's use USB for the connection. Start the software to begin measuring the pulse duration. In the software, go to the tab Setup and click Find Device. Click the icon with the serial number of your pulseCheck NX and finally go to the Measure tab. Here you'll find all necessary settings to control and optimize the measurement. To maximize signal of the autocorrelation, the SHG crystal inside the pulseCheck NX has to be tuned to the wavelength of the laser. For this, you find the signal controls in the Measure tab. Set your wavelength in the tuning input box and the crystal will be tuned automatically. At the same time, observe the data display of the measurement in the software. You see that while tuning the signal starts to increase. In this case, this is a collinear autocorrelation function. On the left-hand side of the software, all control functions are conveniently arranged, whereas on the right-hand side, the data dashboard displays all the measurement results and settings at one glance. If you need further guidance, the small information box in the right bottom will explain each function under the mouse arrow. If you want to change from collinear to non-collinear mode, simply turn the previously mentioned beam distance screw to the documented value. By adjusting the beam distance screw, you can always switch between non-collinear and collinear mode. In non-collinear mode, Two separated beams are visible on the crosshair. We hope this video will help you installing and using pulseCheck NX. If you have any questions, our support team is always ready to help you. On behalf of APE, thank you for your interest and attention.